All right, well, welcome. You are here in the Laurie Student Center orientation and training. I commit that it will be just over an hour of illuminating information, hopefully. I'm really glad for those of you who are able to join. And I love being able to get to know folks as much as we can during this time. So we will be using Mentimeter as an engagement platform during this time. If there's anything that you need in terms of accommodation, that it's hard to hear me, turn your volume up as much as possible. This will be available on YouTube also with closed captioning if you miss anything. So we'll also send out an email with some information. But for now, let's go and get started. So knowing your platform a little bit, welcome to Zoom. I'm guessing many of you are familiar with this platform, and for those of you who aren't, you see kind of what we do in front. I'll ask you to chat at me a few times. That chat button is at the bottom on your screen. Awesome. Some of you are finding it already and chatting at me. Those reactions are super fun. You can do thumbs up. You can do applause. You can do whatever, you know, just throw a little affirmation my way late in the day on a Monday. And you can see the speaker view or the gallery view in the upper right-hand corner. So when I'm sharing my screen, there's this also cool little thing that I found that there's, you can see a line if you're on a computer, and it, you can shift it to make my screen smaller and the gallery bigger, or vice versa. So I thought that was something pretty cool that I just learned recently. So without further ado, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go over the LSC and talk about what it is, who it is, why it is. We're gonna talk about safety procedures. We are going to acknowledge that we are in some interesting current realities within this pandemic. We're gonna explore the mission that was recently revamped, really connecting into the principles of community, and then overall, throughout it all, demonstrate our commitment to student employees. There will be an attendance sheet at the midway point, and again shared at the end, so that you can let us know who is here, and we commit to getting you an LSC gift if you share that out. So thanks so much. Okay, so we feel it really important to begin by welcoming us into a mindset of the principles of community, that we recognize and acknowledge that we are in a bizarre time. We would be doing these in person, and I believe doing them virtual centers and grounds in the principles of community, of integrity, inclusion, respect, service, and social justice. That these principles of community, we recognize some limitations, and we know that the Laurie Student Center is more than a building. And so thus, we are having these orientations virtually to be accessible to all parts of our population in all the ways that we can, by providing it in person and then asynchronously through YouTube at a later time. So for those of you who just came on, welcome. We're going to have you go to menti.com to prepare in for some of the engagement. So here we go. For those of you who just joined. Okay. So who am I? My name is Emily. I am a proud alumna of CSU. I graduated in 2010, which feels like both simultaneously a minute ago and a very long time ago for my master's, but I'm originally from Alaska. I worked in the LSC for 13 years, which is bananas, and I'm the Assistant Director for Training and Development. I believe that if you work to leave things a little bit better than you found them, that's how we can leave a little bit of a legacy. So that's a little bit about me, and I want to invite you to go to that Mentimeter. And if we have professional staff, if we have student staff, how many years have you been at CSU, whether you're a student or a professional staff? So show me that you got on that Menti. Come on and let me know. Great. Awesome. We've got a little bit of experience in. We've got, oh, they're coming through. Great. Wonderful. So if you hadn't had a chance to respond to this one, we have plenty more, but it looks like we all have a little bit of experience, which means that we had LSC and CSU experience before this bizarre year happened, right? So to our folks who have been around CSU for 2, 3, or 4+ years, welcome back. And hopefully we'll make the most of this year. All right. I want to know, I'm only answering the how are you doing in increments of an hour, because I feel like it can change so rapidly. So I want you to type in a word or an emoji for how you're doing right now. How are you doing right now? Are you hungry? Are you happy? I just had my birthday weekend, so I'm still kind of riding high from that. Some good contemplation going on here. I appreciate it. Oof, that is real. Yeah. Awesome. Oh, someone's got that AC on. Or it is. It only got to 75 today. I woke up this morning and I was like, oh, it's the first day of fall. I can feel it. Did you feel it in the air? Diane's nodding. I feel yes. Yeah. So we got fantastic, happy, cold, chilling, maybe in a variety of the sense of the world. Okay. Feeling some busyness for real. Awesome and dandy. Oh, and someone's not feeling great. Some sick. So I'm sorry about that. Achy. Oh, yeah. Okay. So I'm going to move on from this, but I do want you to think about that there are things that we can look forward to in this semester, right? So kind of ground in the possibility of what this year can be. So you don't have to answer that right now. We're going to keep going for the sake of this time. But my hopes and commitments is that you all will be as present as possible in the ways that you are able. So thank you for those of you who are with me in whatever ways you can. I will commit to, they say 2-minute breaks, but to get you out a little early, they might be 1 minute, just to get you up and stretching and looking away from the computer screen. I know it's a lot of information. I want to keep you engaged. That's my commitment to you. And I want you to leave with questions that we can work to keep finding the answers. And both of us get what you put out, get what you put in. And that goes for me as well. So I'll come 50. And if you bring 50, that is awesome and really appreciate that exchange. So welcome to everyone who is here. Okay. So we're going to do a virtual tour. I don't know, some of you may have been in the LSC recently. Some of you may be working exclusively remotely. But finding this just helps me ground in the why we're all here and the remembrance. So I'm going to have us watch this tour.
Hello, and welcome to a 360-degree tour of the Lori Student Center. The LSC sits in the center of campus and acts as a common space for a wide variety of activities. There's plenty of areas where you can study or just hang out. You can grab a bite to eat between classes. Or even a beer with friends. And shop for the latest technology. Textbooks and school supplies, or some CSU gear. And this is truly just the tip of the iceberg in terms of the various things the LSC has to offer. Check out the description for a link to a playlist that highlights other activities and clubs that reside within the Lori Student Center. And of course, do yourself a favor and come visit the LSC for yourself.
Awesome. Sorry if that made anyone a little seasick. I realized that as I was pulling around. I think it's such cool technology to be able to have 365-degree, but I realized that sometimes if you're not the one driving that, it can get a little a little wonky. So, but I hope that reminds you of this place, right? And in the reminder of place, we remember about feels and the feelings that can come up with that. So there were so many intentional decisions that were made, specifically during the reinvigoration of the Lori Student Center. So it went through a huge renovation, as some of you may know, about 5 or 6 years ago. Anyone here or around during that time, or are you all new LSCers? All right. So during that time, there were a bunch of us in the Mac gym, and we were little squished offices, but it was worth the wait. And what I appreciate about the Lori Student Center and the leadership that was collective and collaborative during this time was there's a number of connections that are value driven. And what I mean by that is there are nods to our Northern Colorado location. So anyone know why the carpet is blue on the first level? Do you know where that is? That's in that Funkin' Lounge. Yep, I see a head nod. Anyone want to come off mute and tell me why? Come on, Rach, I know you know it.
It's the Poudre River.
It is, thank you.
Sorry, I have someone else behind me in a meeting, so I'm going to mute right away, but it's the Cache la Poudre.
Yeah, and then right behind that, you'll see the textile wall nodding to our 14ers. So that's just one of the examples. There is the nod to the Morrill Act from President Lincoln. We have all of the student diversity programs and services, offices and centers, literally in the center of the Lori Student Center. And I think that's really emblematic, right? Because we recognize that the events that take place, the decisions that were made around the places, demonstrate our values. So the fact that we have on the third level, a huge installation with our principles of community means something, right? The fact that on a typical year, the powwow through the Native American Cultural Center hosted by them is centered and grounded necessitates our remembering of our roots and our foundation to recognize that we have a tumultuous past and history with the ancestors and Native populations who still live and inhabit this area, that this land initially was not ours to take, and yet we find ourselves at an institution, and how do we acknowledge, recognize, and move forward with integrity along with communities and populations while grounding in our principles of community. So all of these different ways are ways that I really appreciate that the LSC tries to live out its values. Not done. We've got a lot of ways and work to go, and it's up to each one of us to kind of acknowledge and realize this so that we can embody these values and the mission, which we'll talk about in a moment. Okay, so get back to that Mentimeter. True or false, there was a hurricane in 1997 that took off a portion of the roof. True, false, there was a hurricane in 1997 that took off a portion of the roof. There's a little LSC history here. A little bit of meteorology too. Ooh, I appreciate it. I feel like some of you folks out there know your meteorology. So we have 8 falses, and that is accurate. It is false, A, because hurricanes really only happen in coastal states. So I bet you'll do really well on this next one. Oh, did I take it? Oh, I took it out. So what did happen in 1997 was that there was a flood, and it took out the whole first floor of the Lori Student Center. And so you can even walk or move through the first level of the LSC and see the high water mark. I said at the beginning that the Lori Student Center is more than a place. It's more than a physical structure. It's really about our people and our spaces that make up who the Lori Student Center is. So it's the intention that's put into making sure that we earn your patronage within the bookstore. That the bookstore was the 2017 Collegiate Retailer of the Year. That means across the board. They're working really hard to get you to purchase through the bookstore, which goes directly back to you all, specifically as employees in and of the Lori Student Center. That they want you to come to the bookstore instead of hitting that button on Amazon. We want you to pass right by Starbucks to come into the Sweet Sensations, right? We want you to feel a certain way so that you will come and re-engage and reinvest your time, talent, and money back into the Lori Student Center. And we'll talk about that why in a second. And much of it revolves around the people of who it is. This is an excerpt from an email that a colleague of mine actually received, that CSU is a great place because of people like you. And we hear this all the time, that people come on tours when they're ready to come to CSU and they're like, I don't know, it was just kind of a feeling I got. Everyone was seemed really kind, and we're working on that, right? We definitely have kind of an energy about, and we know that that's not everybody's shared experience, but that each one of us has the opportunity through the ways that we behave to ensure that people have great experiences in and of the Lori Student Center. Okay, so you're like, cool, but like, what is, great, Sweet Sensations is the best. Lori Student Center can be seen as an umbrella, okay? So right in the middle of that umbrella, we have the executive director's team. And this is a team that's made up of programming entities. So they're the folks who help with the room reservations and with the catering. They oversee the dining establishment, and it even includes campus activities that does a bunch of the events and the slice office. And so we'll talk about that. But the executive director's team is what is kind of considered Lori Student Center. And what is really important to realize about this umbrella is there are many entities that are both CSU related and not CSU related that find home in the LSC. So that's why the handle of the umbrella kind of keeps it up and keeps things going so that other spaces can find home in the LSC, which we'll talk about. The executive director's team is headed up by Dr. Mike Ellis. And this does include some of the ones that I talked about and mentioned. So CoLab, our marketing, our environmental service and maintenance would be remiss if we looked over that. That is necessary, and we'll talk about why in a moment. The Aspen Grill, catering, et cetera. These are all part of the executive director's team. Under that umbrella, and one of the CSU clusters, is the Student Diversity Programs and Services Cluster. Having worked for the Pride Center before, Pride Resource Center, it has a warm spot in my heart, and Dr. Kathy Cisneros heads up this cluster. So the seven identity-focused educational and programming spaces that can be found on the third and second levels of the Lori Student Center. Some also have what are called satellite offices located in the LSC and then can be found elsewhere. So Student Disability Center, and the Women and Gender Advocacy Center also are located externally to the Lori Student Center. Next we have, headed up by Dr. Jody Donovan, our Dean of Students, the Campus Life Cluster. Four of these offices are found in the LSC, and the others, student case management and down, are found in outside of the LSC. So ALVS, Adult Learner Intervention Services, Off-Campus Life, Fraternity and Sorority Life, and Student Legal Services are found in the LSC. And this is where I like to say that if you have legal questions, if you have counseling needs or interests, if you have hopes for rent and a new home buying class, these are what your student fees pay for that some people don't even realize, right? So get that legal advice, utilize those services, go to your identity-based centers through SDPS. It's all there for you and operating either virtually or in person this semester. True or false, the Pride Resource Center and the Office of Fraternity and Sorority Life used to be connected. True or false? I got one person. Get back on that Mentimeter. Come on. Yes. Nice, nice. Ooh, all right. We're getting a split here. Very nice. All right. Cool. Great. So we have a split here, and in their forms right now, it's false. However, the Pride Resource Center used to be called GLBT Student Services. And the Office of Attorney and Sorority Life used to be called the Greek Life Office. So you can see that much in the Laurie Student Center and at CSU has evolved, including the names. And those two offices were not only connected and joined, but they shared an administrative assistant as well. So there are lots of ways that offices collaborate and are good stewards of the fee, stewards of our student fees, that really think and are thoughtful about how we utilize funds together. So that's just that was obviously before renovation. Okay. So also in the LSC, there are a number of CSU associated and then business partners. So your student government, ASCSU, is found in the LSC, as well as the Career Center, RAM Tech, the RAM Card Office, and a variety of others. We'll talk a little bit about the LSC Governing Board at the end. And then our business partners are ones that you're familiar with. I did leave out Taco Bell. I cannot believe that I forgot. It's one of my frequented areas. And I spelled Garbanzo wrong, so apologies to those two. But we've got Subway, Panda Express, Transport, James Salon, et cetera. Continue with the food and beverages. We have all of our event services. I really appreciate bringing out and pulling out that we have businesses by and for CSU. So through our hospitality major, as well as focusing on business, we have these businesses that are managed and run and staffed by students. And that is a huge commitment to our student employees. We also have some, so if you see the umbrella, imagine that the umbrella has some streamers going out, and those streamers are the Beyond the Building folks. We have Sweet Temptations, Morgan's Grind, Lake Street Market, and Bean Counter that bring that philosophy and energy of the LSC around campus. Okay, so I want to hear and see what your favorite yummy spot is in the LSC. I only have a couple right there, so if it's different, type in the chat. What is your other one? What am I missing? What needs to make this? Sandwiches at 50-30 though. Oh man, bagel place. Pizza bagel, anyone? That's my personal favorite. Yeah. Sweet Sensations, yes, have to have some love. I'm looking at the chat, anything different? Seems like we've, someone have some love on Bachelor Wrap. That's awesome. You know, that's the one establishment that didn't open for this semester. It has full plans to come back next semester, but for right now, Bagel Place 2 specifically. Yes, I feel like they're the ones who run out of Consuelo's burritos last. So I go to. Awesome. Okay, so it's important to talk about where the money comes from, right? It takes about $36 million to run the student center, and that includes all of the salaries and the pay for students, all of that. And 75% of that comes through revenue. So when I said they're working really hard to get you to buy your coffee from Sweet Sensations and your books from the bookstore, that's because that revenue that comes back in gets immediately dispersed back into the student experience. Student fees do account for 25% of the student budget or of the LSC budget. And so we're really grateful for the students out there that allow these services and happenings to be possible. Question, how many students work in or with the Laurie Student Center? Your options are more than 200, 400, 600, or 800 students. Someone pointed out that if you do the more than 200, then you're automatically going to get it right, because oddly worded question, or I'm like, $1, Bob. That's a Price is Right reference that I'm not sure how many people are going to get. Okay. Awesome. All right. So we have a variety coming in. This is great. The answer is technically 650 if we're looking at that handle of the Laurie Student Center. If you go beyond, it's over 900 student employees. So student media alone employs and has on their payroll over 100 students. And you start thinking about all the folks that come in and out, that is so many students that we're committing employment and hours to that could take a professional staff over it at any time. Just FYI, there's a lot of power in students. So, awesome on that one. Okay, so again, my commitment to you, I know it's 4:30. Welcome you to turn off your screens if you want, take a look away from the computer, look at least 20 feet away. Stretch it out. I'm going to get a good arm stretch and come back at 31.
Si el ritmo te lleva a mover la cabeza y empezamos como es. Mi música no discrimina a nadie, así que vamos a romper. Toda mi gente se mueve, mira el ritmo como los tiene. Hago música que entretiene, el mundo nos quiere, me quiere a mí. Toda mi gente se mueve, mira el ritmo como los tiene. Hago música que entretiene, mi música los tiene fuerte bailando y se baila así.
All right, start joining me back. Our little stretch break, awesome, thank you. I hope you answered that quick text that came in the middle. I hope you answered, you know, got up and did whatever you needed to. Come back on that video if you don't mind. So nice to see you all. Okay. I did put in the chat the attendance link, so at a point in the near future, you can go to that attendance link and just make sure to fill it out. Now, we are over a third of the way done, don't you worry. I would say we're about at the halfway part. We're gonna talk about health, safety, and emergency. Talk about some COVID realities all the way to what we might do in an active assailant situation. So, at this time, I will let some of my favorite colleagues do the work and watch this video.
Hello. The goal of this short video is to inform us on how we can return to physically working in the Lori Student Center building and spaces around campus while keeping the health of others and ourselves at the top of mind and centered in the ways we act. We know there are behaviors which will reduce the spread of COVID-19. When coming to work physically, those behaviors are very important. This video will provide 4 steps to follow each day you come to work physically. Step 1. Complete the daily symptom checker. Take your temperature. Assess your symptoms and whether you've tested positive or been in contact with someone who has tested positive for COVID-19 in the past 2 weeks. Ideally, this will be done prior to coming into the physical workspace. We highly encourage your temperature be taken at home prior to coming to work. If that is not possible, thermometers are available at the LSC. The form should be completed each day you come to campus, either for class or work. If you are experiencing symptoms of COVID-19, let your supervisor know as soon as possible. Also, if you are not working but experiencing symptoms of COVID-19, you are expected to complete the form as soon as possible, regardless if you are scheduled for an in-person shift or not. This ensures contact tracing can begin and keep our community as healthy as possible. Step 2. While working in the LSC building and spaces, face coverings must be worn. Some of your jobs and responsibilities will require different personal protective equipment or PPE. Talk with your supervisor about what the expectations are for your area. If you have a disability or have discussed face coverings with the Student Disability Center, please talk to your supervisor. Step 3. Clean your work area at the beginning and end of your shift. When you arrive to work, take time to clean your work area. Wash your hands prior to coming to work. Disinfectant spray and wipes are available in each area for your health and convenience. Consider everything you will touch during your shift, and if possible, wipe down each area. When you have completed your shift, disinfect these areas again for the next staff member. Each department will have specific requirements, so please talk to your supervisor about cleaning procedures. Step 4. continue to provide excellent customer care and service. The core of the LSC is the student experience of our programs and services. Each of you has the ability to influence how people show up at the LSC. Through grounding in CSU's principles of community, we can treat others and ourselves in ways which promote health, community, and connection. Remember to maintain physical distancing throughout your shift and when interacting with others. Engage with people and ask if they need assistance. Continue to provide the exceptional care the LSC is known for. We are grateful to each of you and could not do what we do or be who we are without you.
Hello, Lori Student Center employees. I hope you're doing well. I'm Mike Ellis, Executive Director of the LSC and Assistant Vice President for Student Affairs. I want to take a brief moment to thank you both for your participation in this program and for making a choice to work in the Lori Student Center. The LSC is a special place on our campus, and it's because of our employee base, which consists primarily of students, which makes it special, if not magical. When people come to or experience the LSC remotely, they'll encounter a staff which makes them feel welcomed, valued, and engaged. We know this doesn't happen by chance, and so it's my sincere hope to convey my appreciation for all that you do. You have our very best wishes for a great semester, and remember, Rams take care, Rams take action.
Here are a few questions we thought may come up for you as we move into in-person work environments. What do I do if someone isn't wearing or won't wear a face covering? Face coverings may be available at many of the front desks and counters of frontline service areas. If someone is not wearing one, you may ask if they need one and offer it to them. If the person refuses, connect with your supervisor. There is a team of professional staff who will interject and handle the situation if it escalates. What changes will I see when I come into the LSC? The summer has been spent preparing for the fall semester and the LSC reopening its physical locations. You will see an increase of signage with reminders and directions, plexiglass dividers at different frontline service desks, and a variety of other installments. What we hope does not change is the level and quality of service people receive when visiting the Lori Student Center. You may have other questions coming up. We encourage you to have open conversations with your supervisor about anything you have questions about related to COVID-19 and CSU. While they may know much of what's going on, they also may not immediately have the answers. Together, you can work to find them.
Super grateful to the students who did that video. And it was true. Mike Ellis likes to say that we believe that the student employees can do it better, more innovatively, more creatively than pro staff can at any junction. And this was totally true. I came with like a script and they're like, why don't we do this? And why don't we do this? And I was like, oh man, I should have just given this project to you. So yeah, absolutely, the tech squad. So all the students were just super great to work with, and I was really glad to do that and that we were able to have that be part of it. So looking at that, get back to that Mentimeter, and I wanna see what was a takeaway from the video? Maybe a feeling that you had, something that you learned. What's one takeaway from the video that we have? Yeah. Awesome. For the last few that are coming in, once you're done, check out these answers. Definitely around staying safe and keeping each other safe. I love that we have agency. It really is up to all of us as cliche as that sounds, we have the ability to make choices and choices about our behaviors each day. What to do if someone isn't wearing a mask, that is really important, that it is not on the shoulders of student employees to intervene in a hostile situation. If there's someone not wearing a mask, there are people to tap, and you can do that by calling the building manager or connecting with your supervisor, and the pro staff will come and take care of it. Always keep visitors of LSC our top priority and have fun. I love that. And yes, nod to the actors and keeping work areas clean. Thanks. There has been a huge committee around social norming and how to just make it part of the new normal to recognize that, you know, my face covering protects you and your face covering protects me. That really it has to be around a collective mindset. And that people are really committed to staying on campus and to being in person for those who are able. And that can't happen if some of these realities aren't realized and actualized, not only in buildings, but in your social environments too. There are tons of folks who are making really great choices in their classes or in the Lori Student Center, but not doing it at gatherings outside or at establishments in Fort Collins. And we need to do it kind of consistently so we can keep in person. All right, so that's a little bit about our current COVID realities. And now we're gonna talk about things that might just happen on a typical year, like a snow day in May, which can happen in Colorado. Might also be because of climate change, and it also might be because we're in Colorado. So recognizing, just connect with your supervisor first if there's a snow day. The LSC is one of the last entities to close because of its connection to transport, our public transportation. We got to get people home. So unless you're working at the info desk, chances are good that you will be released from work for that day. But that also is hard, right? For some of us who are working hourly or some of us who need to stay behind, just recognize, you know, when you're like, oh, was that snow day, that there's a lot that goes into those decisions. And for some folks, if you're not making the money or doing the hours, you're not making that money. And so there is a lot that goes into the factors around a snow day. Okay, so at this point, I would invite folks around evacuation and knowing your exits to journey with me into Avatar Land, either Sims or Second Life or something. And wherever your little avatar usually is, whether that be in the Sunken Lounge or up in the EPO office or at Bagel Place 2, find your nearest exit. Something happened, an alarm went off, and you got to find the nearest exit. You find it, you see it. Oh, you can't use that one. There's like flames or something. There's something in the way. Where is your alternative exit? Around your avatar, find it. Okay, join me back. So hopefully your avatar made it out safely because you knew your alternative exit. We have something, right? If you if there are folks who have been on a plane before in this virtual room, maybe not recently because of the current climate, but they have the saying of you put your own mask on before someone else's. We have first responders who are going to be here and very quick to respond. And so make sure that you're getting yourself out and that you're safe and that we have notified the proper folks. Hey, Brian, nice to see you. So some incredible humans spent a very long time on this map. Each of those little dots representing something. I don't know if you can see my cursor. Can you see my cursor when I do that? Oh, good. Okay. So over here, we've got the, just to orient you, the theater. We have transport down here. This is the food court. Slices right here. And so this is only level 200. So I'll send out material that you can click. It's all available through website too. But it is just helpful to know and recognize where your exits are, as well as know what some of these little dots are. So that goes to the next question. On that Mentimeter, true or false, if zombies attacked the Lori Student Center, we would be prepared. True, false, or define prepared. Nice. I like the votes of confidence, skeptical confidence. Throw in some falses there too, that's fair too. Nice, all right. So I jest a little bit about this question, and I say define prepared, right? Because it goes to the next part. we have what are called emergency kits. And in my mind, that only equates to zombie preparedness kits, because these are not first aid kits. Hopefully in each of your respective offices or locations in the LSC, you have first aid kits that if something happens. But these are going to be your, you know, 5-gallon barrels, your fire blankets, your water filtration system, flashlights, flares, things like that. Things that in an emergency, if we needed to hunker down or hunker in, maybe there was a tornado or something happened, zombies attacked, we needed to kind of cloister in. In a pandemic, we usually spread out and disperse, right? We don't want to come in many people in large areas, but these emergency kits exist on level 1, 2, and 300. Now raise your hand for those of you who I can see. Is anyone trained on an AED, an automated external defibrillator? Yep, got a couple. Nice. Okay, awesome. The good news, you don't have to be trained on one to use one. You just have to know that they're there. And these are one of those things, like, you don't think that's going to happen, right? You don't think someone's going to have a cardiac experience right next to you, but bam, someone's on the ground and you're like, oh my gosh, first call 911, right? First out, call 911. Anyone know what you tell 911 first thing out your mouth? Anyone put it in the chat or come off mute? Yes, I saw where you are. Location, tell them where you are. We have a 2 to 3 minute response time from our CSU PD because we have a police department directly associated with CSU, which is awesome. It's 5 to 7 minutes. If your cell phone goes through the dispatch just to general Fort Collins. So always tell location. And then when you know that there's an AED over by the elevators, you bring it out, it's a little box, you open the door, grab it, and then it's all ready, hopefully when the first responders get there. But it has a nice soothing mechanical voice that walks you through all of the process. It's like, expose the chest of the victim, put pads on the victim. Take a deep breath in, relax. Like it even tells you to like calm down about the situation. It's pretty great. So it's really user-friendly and statistically they are exceedingly meant to help increase the probability that people will live through a cardiac event. Okay. So our go-to people, if anything happens, are our building managers. They are just awesome. Are any of us building managers here on the call? I just love giving a shout out to them. They are just awesome. They have been trained in a number of situations or circumstances. They are our people who we call also if there are mask non-wearers in the LSC and they can route to the appropriate people. If there are any minor emergencies, call them, right? So maybe someone cuts their hand pretty badly and there's blood on the floor. Call your building managers. They'll get with our environmental services because they have the biohazard training to clean up hazardous waste and can be taken care of, right? So our building managers are great and they do a lot in the LSC. Okay, so at this point in time, usually, I would click that link and we would watch, it goes to about a 12-minute video on active assailant situations. Again, not something that's great to talk about and the reality requires it. It recognizes that in our time and place in society, people make choices to come in and do irreparable harm to people without knowledge of who they are. And the Lori Student Center being a highly populated place, it's important to recognize that that could be a situation. So if you find yourself in a physical situation in the Lori Student Center, this video is going to walk you through what to do, and I'll send that out afterwards. So I encourage you to watch it. Bit of a trigger warning, right? It's pretty violent, and it puts you in very real situations, and so that's why we get the choice to watch it. But really, it just gets you thinking about, again, you don't want to think that there's a cardiac event that happens. You don't want to think that someone's going to come in and want to do harm to a bunch of people in the place that you're working in. We just don't know what's going to happen, right? So where you are, it goes over run, hide, fight, right? If you had your little avatar and you know your exit, you can exit the premises and that's your first, right? Run. Hide if you are in an office location, if you have doors that can close, if you can dark out those windows, if you can turn off the lights, if you can disperse and hide under desks, etc. That's going to be your second option. That's hide. So run, hide. The last, and what we hope it doesn't get to, but might be a reality, is that if someone comes into the premises, you weaponize anything that's around you, chairs, computers, Well, I mean, I don't know. I mean, you'd be creative. And usually if you're with other people, you would try to take them out and take them down. So fight is that third, and it's third option for a reason, right? Run, hide, fight. And really what we want you to do is be like a cat. We want you to be observant. We want you to recognize that working in and of the Lori Student Center requires that we pay attention to the people who are around us, right? And be, you know, kind of that see something, say something. Don't be quiet in these situations or scenarios. I think it was something like there were 42 incidents of questionable behavior from the shooter in Virginia Tech. And just none of those people had put together the pieces to say this person is disturbed and is potentially violent, and it resulted in tragedy. So we want folks to be relaxed and calm, but to pay attention and to report those things like odd behavior. This goes into, I know I'm talking a lot, thank you for continuing paying with your paid attention. This next one's a hard one to talk about because I feel like all of us are potentially on the brink of something right now. We are in a contentious election year that's situated within a racial reckoning in our country and arguably the world in a global pandemic. There is a lot going on, and that's just on a societal level. That's not recognizing the finances of college, the interpersonal relationships in your life, all of those. So when we say report odd behavior, it's really just checking in on each other, right? It's recognizing that if Diane and I are in the same shifts all the time, and you know, 1 month, like we're hanging out all the time, and then the next month, like she starts to recognize like my mood's behaving a little bit, and I'm like kind of lashing out erratically, and she asked me to hang out like 3 or 4 times, and each time I blow her off. And she could just stop at that and be like, wow, Emily's kind of being a jerk recently. She could put all of it together and say, actually, she did just say that she failed a chemistry exam and she aced chemistry last year and she's been isolated a lot, right? All of these kind of indicators recognize that someone might not be okay. When I was in a webinar this summer that just said, assume these days that people are not okay, that upping our check-ins on people, now is the right time to do that. Right? Because we want to be in community. We want Rams to take care of Rams. We want to see each other and feel that sense of belonging. So reporting that behavior, check in with your supervisor. See if you can do, if you do tell someone. Tell someone is an anonymous resource that you can say, you know, something might be going on. Can you do a wellness check? Professors, staff members, student to student, it's just a checking in and checking with each other. To tell someone also goes to, there's an opportunity to do a bias report. So through the Support and Safety, Office of Support and Safety, which you'll see that number right there, you can also go to that website through an online referral form and report incidents of biases. And these kind of hold as like a clearinghouse of information and that keeps tabs on our community and checks in on us so things like Virginia Tech don't happen on the extreme end of the spectrum. And on an everyday, day-to-day, it demonstrates a sense of care. It demonstrates resources that we have available to us, like we're going to talk about on the next slide. So some of these things are hard to talk about, right? Some of these acknowledgement around the fact that crises happen is really important. So each of us on this call, if we're associated and working with the Lori Student Center, are what we call responsible employees. When you break down the word responsible and employees, it means that because you're employed, you have a certain responsibility to connect people in with resources that are available to them. If people experience Title IX aggressions to sexual harassment, sexual violence, stalking, or the variety of those 6 bullet points, it needs to be reported. And that sounds scarier than it needs to be. What that means is that if Cassidy and I are hanging out and Cassidy's like, hey, how was your weekend? Like we're at our shift at Sweet Sensations. Cassidy, I'm not quite sure where you work, but you know, somewhere. So we're working in the Lori Student Center and I was like, yeah, you know, like the weekend was okay, but like my ex has been super on my case. And Cassidy's like, yeah, what's going on? And it's like, well, you know, like first it was just like a bunch of texts late at night and it was like really annoying and it just kept waking me up. But then like the next night they showed up at my door and like wouldn't leave. And Cassie's like, Em, I think something's going on. Like that sounds kind of scary. Like let's talk to someone else because that you shouldn't have to be dealing with that alone. That's the key, right? You shouldn't have to be dealing with that alone. But lots of people feel like they have to hold on to this. These situations happen a lot more than we want to acknowledge. And to realize that we don't have to do this alone is the key part. So Cassie might say to me, hey, let's go talk to our supervisor and I'll go with you to WGAC or something of that nature. When we report to support and safety assessment and do that report within 24 hours, again, you don't have to do that report alone. I'm talking my student employees here, right? Working with your supervisors, getting that the resources to be able to make that report is really important. Because then again, it acts as that clearinghouse. And then if someone, like say my ex, is also hurting someone else, stalking someone else, then we can put those pieces together. So being a responsible employee means that we want to get people connected into the resources, some confidential, and some where they have agency to move forward in how they want. If you have any questions about this, this is kind of murky water. I'd be happy to stay with you after and answer any questions about them and also come visit my virtual office hours or shoot me an email because I want you to make sense of this. Also, if you have questions, feel free to put them in the chat and I will address them. Yes, thank you, Cassidy. So the victims assistance team, which is the second to last bullet point on the slide, has like is a great way to answer questions, even if you want to be like, so hypothetically, if this were going on, what could happen, right? So if I'm supporting this person, what are my options? The victims assistance team is awesome. Thank you, Cassidy, for putting that up there. Okay. Yes, I'm going to give you 30 seconds. We're on like the home stretch. So wherever you are, just move back from your computer, stretch it out. I'm not even going to play the music. Oh my gosh. You can't see it, but my dog, my healer, is doing a downward dog right now. She was stretching. She was stretching too right now. Okay. You good? All right. She's ready. We're ready too. Okay. So we've talked about what the Lori Student Center is, who, when, where. We've talked about some emergency procedures, health, safety, et cetera. And now is the time where we get to talk about care. We get to talk about our how and our why and our philosophy of the Lori Student Center. So this is our home stretch. I want you to first think about a time. I want you to think about a time in your life that you felt really good. Like you felt like you mattered. You felt like you belonged. You felt like maybe it was your third grade science fair. Maybe it was your dance class in high school. Maybe it was a dinner at a friend's house that you haven't seen in a really long time. Maybe it was going to work. Maybe it was that class that you got that A in. So think of any time in your past, in your current, where you felt like you were included, important, valued, and connected to others, that you were respected for who you are. So I want you to think about some words. You don't have to tell what the memory was. But hold that memory in your mind, and I want you to think about some words that you would associate with that memory. And again, anonymously, I want you to go to Mentimeter and type in those words that you associate with that memory. You're feeling good, you're feeling valued, you're feeling like you belong. What are some words? These are awesome. Valued, strong, fulfilled, thankful, important, confident, belonging, life-changing, community. These are not light words. These are life-changing, right? These are accomplished. I love that. These are when we have no idea about the impact of maybe a small behavior, right? That smile through the eyes to someone. I've noticed that it's a lot harder to engage people just from a one-to-one with masks, kind of just walking through the Lori Student Center. But I do my best to try to smile through my eyes, right? But it's those little ways that we can connect in. Because when you think of that feeling or sense of belonging, that memory that I hope that you have, that's the kind of energy that we want felt in the Lori Student Center. Inclusion goes beyond invitation. It's not just like, yeah, everybody can come through the doors, everyone can like access the Zoom link virtually. It's being welcomed, valued, and affirmed, right? It's recognizing the gratitude for those of you who are able and willing to be on video with me right now, right? It's that recognition that that you all are humans, and that I'm human, and that we're here, and that we're feeling valued and affirmed in this time. So it goes beyond invitation. We believe that if we work towards inclusion, then we are working towards being excellent. That excellence must invite a variety of perspectives, diverse backgrounds, differences of thought. Higher education hinges on critical thinking, right? It goes beyond numbers. It's not about the numbers and the fact that it's everyone's responsibility. We think about it in a broad variety, so it's easy to just be like, oh, it's not a very diverse place. Well, what do you mean when you say diverse? There's a ton of different aspects of diversity. So when we say diverse, CSU specifically is talking about 17 different categories or categorizations, and it goes beyond this, right? But whether folks are of different ages, sexes, familial status, disability, national origin, having different ideas or perspectives, socioeconomic status, this is kind of an encompassing variety of all the different ways that we can come, that are just a little bit nuanced from folks, that we have a lot of similarities in values, in that we all want love and security and community, and how that manifests can look really different. And I think we are encouraged to think about how different we are rather than how similar we are, right? But then when we find grounding and we find a shared sense of why, that we're at CSU and part of this larger community for a reason, we can ground in that. The thing is that identity, culture, and experiences, they're always present. So wherever you were right before now, you're bringing all that into the Zoom room with you, right? You might be thinking about that biology lab that you need to finish. You might be thinking about that book report that has to be done, or the common read, or all of those different things, or the fact that your family might be struggling, or it's your dad's birthday, or things like that. You bring all of that here, and I just get you for a split second, right? I just get you in this time where I'm seeing just a snapshot. And when we interact with people within the Lori Student Center, we're just getting them for a snapshot too. And so if someone lashes out or if someone's really frustrated, when we talk about collective, or when we talk about customer care, we want you to think about that there's a lot that they're bringing into that that you might not even be seeing, right? To serve the mission of the Lori Student Center is all of our responsibilities as staff members, that we are a student-centered organization that's at the heart of campus, who provides programs and services that create an inclusive community and inspire active, engaged learning. Less than 28 words, but in it, each one was specifically crafted. It was rebranded, reinvigorated in 2020 to come out and be powerful and hopefully embodied by you all. So look at that for a moment. And then let me know what words stand out to you. Which ones do you remember? Which ones do you feel are at the core and crux of who the LSC is? Give that 15 more seconds. So the ones being seen tend to be, from what I've seen from doing this presentation, the ones that come out first, right? To see inclusive inclusion, being student-centered, and I love that it's in the middle, that heart, create learning. Yes, all of these are at the core of why the Student Center exists. It's not just a building, it's a why, right? It's to provide these events and programs and services that encourage learning in an inclusive environment that is community-centered. It's at the heart of campus. So that's great. We recognize that the mission is again held within this umbrella of a larger community of our principles of community. We've talked about this before: inclusion, integrity, respect, service, and social justice, and how important it is to know that this is a journey, not a destination that we have achieved. That each of the things that we do to try to work towards being in community with each other hinges on these principles. We have a philosophy of customer care. It goes beyond customer service. Service is important, right? But especially in those times when we want to encourage your place to belong, your place to learn, your place to study, your place to eat, your place to gather in these ways that we can, either virtually or in person this year, that it grounds in the LSC philosophy of customer care, being listen, support, and care. And that is right. It is a kitschy acronym for LSC. I didn't make it up. It encourages us, right? If Brian has come into encounter with me and Brian works at a place and I come in and I'm like grumbling about my financial aid and Brian's like, I don't know anything about financial aid. But Brian just listens to me. Brian just lets me finish and takes a breath and I keep going. And in that moment, I am so pissed. I just want to be heard and felt by someone. I just want someone to see me. And in that moment, Brian takes a couple seconds and then supports it through acknowledging that, man, that sounds really frustrating. I'm really sorry that you're going through that right now. I know when I worked with financial aid or whatever, right? But it's that supporting, it's that feeling validated. I'm like, I know, right? I know they're working their butts off, but my gosh, like, can't we just get my account right? Or whatever it is. I don't mean to gripe on it, financial aid. I know they're working really hard, right? But Brian in that moment supports it, acknowledges it, and then works to say, you know, I bet we could find a number together, right? Or I bet we could, you know, do that. And goes that extra step to go online and help me find it for me or something like that. But it might not even be in his wheelhouse. it might not be in under his duties as assigned, but it's that extra little care that can be demonstrated through that listening, supporting, and caring. Also, when you, this was from the research, but using people's favorite word, their name, that does not mean that we are egocentric or like hyper arrogant. It's that we feel like we belong when we hear ourselves, right? So like when I acknowledge that Haley's here with us and Catherine's here with us, right? That we want it to encourage that place and that sense of belonging. Is our last content slide, I promise. And then I tell you about some opportunities that we have. Every 2 years, a fantastic coordinator named Michael Marr puts out and works on the Sky Factor assessment. And it goes out to gather a slew of students in CSU, but also across the country based on their student center. Students are asked to respond based on how they're experiencing their student union or student center. And these are some of the indicators that folks said over and over again, that it is perceived as a safe place, that the restrooms are really clean, which might seem like this minor thing, but based on how clean we think of environments, that's also how we show up and behave in environments. That's a little nod to campus ecology by Dr. Jim Banning, that when we are in an environment and we perceive how we can interact with it, the cleanliness and the enjoyability of it encourages us to show up in that way. We're so glad that it's seen as a student-oriented facility because that's at the core of our mission, that we, meaning all of us in this virtual room, are courteous and have a positive environment. These are huge, right? There are areas that we can work on. There are areas that we did not get a high rating. And these were ones where it's really important to recognize what we do well so we can keep doing them. So that's a gratitude and a thanks to you all. That through your work in the Laurie Student Center, we want you to have exposure to these learning objectives. That regardless of where you work, whether you're a theater tech, whether you are a person who works on videos, whether you are helping with serving food, all of those things, we want you to have exposure to leadership and teamwork, workflow planning, decision making, intercultural fluency, and the list goes on. But if you don't feel like you get that, through your direct supervisory contact, working with your supervisor and through different professional development shape.colostate.edu, I'll show you at the end, has a variety of asynchronous professional development. I know that many of you on this call are under a slew of assignments and tests and virtual and in-person classes, so I don't mean to put anything else on you, but I want you to recognize that the work that you all do, we see it as a leadership and educational opportunity as well. To get involved through involvement advising, registered student organizations, which the involvement fair is starting virtually and online today through the 14th. So checking out our student organizations that are open for membership, and then being a part of different committees. I'll share this one out with you so you don't feel like you need to capture all of this right now. But a really great opportunity that I want to highlight is to be on the Lori Student Center Governing Board. This is where we need student and staff voices to discuss and debate and talk about policies and proposals that are in the Lori Student Center and really great leadership opportunity to really influence and impact change in the LSC. The Real Experience, we're doing a little bit different this year, but they are workshops that are available, and we're working with supervisors a little later in the semester to provide them to staff for professional development, but connect with myself actually or Rachel if you're interested in the RAMS engaging in active leadership. And then you are in a SHAPE offering. SHAPE is the LSC employee training and development program that offers these orientations, all of that virtual professional development I mentioned, and a variety of events throughout the year. I'm really, really, really glad that you joined me this evening. I tried to keep it and cut it much less than an hour and a half, and I hope you feel that. I'm really grateful. Thank you so much. I am going to put the attendance link one more time. So if folks would make sure to fill that out, let me know if you have any questions. I'm grateful for you. And if you wouldn't mind coming off mute before you say you take off and say goodbye, that would be great.
Adios.
Bye. Thanks, Brian.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely.
Bye. Thank you.
Have a great day.
Thank you.